on?
Yeah, it is.
We are here in the Ateneo de Manila. We are going to document this is the Grand Horacio de la Costa building where there are the famous teachers of... Oh my God!
What? Dude, are you okay? Hey, dude!
Where's the nearest infirmary?
Oh my God! Help! Oh my God! Dude!
Good evening, Philippines. The recent epidemic MEV1 that has struck the world did not spare our country. Millions of people have died from the disease around the world. 1 in 5 people infected are killed. In only a span of 3 months, 1 billion of the world's population has been infected. With the use of tracing, the American Center for Disease Control, the leading investigator of the disease, and the World Health Organization, has identified that the disease has originated from Hong Kong, which is the 11th most populated country by our own numbers, with 200,987 people. The widespread panic in Hong Kong caused numerous OFWs to immediately head home before the statewide quarantine was initiated. The disease spread globally in a matter of days. This statement was released by the Hong Kong government just
yesterday. 每一个在世界航海贸易无限，这是突然不可免的。这种疾病不会蔓延，特别是考虑到它的爆发是如此。
An estimate of 143,636 OFWs were able to return home to the Philippines while carrying the virus, making our country one of the largest. And how are things in the streets?
Yes. It's sad to say, but if there was anywhere that you could describe the situation, it would be panic. Pure and utter panic. Suppose viewers such as the first Cynthia, being promoted by the American blogger, are popping up everywhere. What the hell? Panic people are overwhelming the pharmacies to get the supposed viewers this accelerated spread of the disease as healthy and infected people congregate. There have been cases of looting, breaking, entering, and even murders. Religious fanatics have gone to see preaching this is the end of the world.
The end of the world is near! Oh my God, repent people, repent! Embrace nature, embrace! Pray to the Lord, Lord, Lord! The end of the world! Save me from this massacre, of this disease, or whatever this virus, whatever this chaos you have given us. Please, Lord, nature, nature, this will save me. This is all natural. This is given by the Lord, not given by the humans. Not given. I need to take off everything. Help me, Lord, help me. Save me, Lord, save me.
Back to you.
Thank you, Pakasar. The government has announced that it has been taking measures to attend to the disease and that the Araneta Stadium has been transformed into an evacuation center because the hospitals can no longer keep up with the influx of patients. Similar actions to quarantine the sick and dispose of the infected dead are being used around the country and in the world. We go to our correspondent who is in the scene at St. Francis Hospital.
Thank you. I am here in St. Francis Hospital, and as you can see, the hospital is filling to the brim. There are not enough beds, and the medical staff, doctors, and nurses have taken its fair share of deaths due to the virus. Hospitals all over the country are extremely undermanned. According to the investigations being done, the characteristics of the virus can be likened to the Nipah disease discovered in South Africa. Those who have been infected have experienced neurologic problems, inflammation of the brain and respiratory complications, seizures, and foaming of the mouth. virus was discovered to have genetic material transmitted from infected pigs. It spreads via fomites, any inanimate objects capable of carrying infectious organisms and transferring it from one individual to another. The virus has a basic reproduction number of 2, meaning an infected person can potentially infect 2 more people. The speed at which this disease has spread pales in comparison to SARS back in 2003 and H1N1 back in 2009. Back to the studio.
The successful cultivation of the virus has led to the discovery of a vaccine a month after the start of the MEV1 epidemic. A lottery system based on the birth date is the selection process used to distribute the vaccine. A lot of the actions undertaken by the American Center for Disease Control are coming under fire. Only a few investigators were sent out to disease hotspots around the world to investigate the disease. Some critics also doubt the effectiveness of the supposed vaccine since it did not go through proper avenues of testing. This just in. Renowned epidemiologist Dr. John Q. Wong was kidnapped by the NPA when he was tracking the spread of the disease. They're holding him hostage until they are ensured vaccines. Thank you.